Hi, I'd like to share with you Lambda AI's exciting progress on domain-specific large vision models. The large language model, or LLM revolution, has transformed how we process text. And the large vision model, or LVM revolution, is just starting to change how we process images as well. But there's one important difference between LLMs and LVMs. Internet text sounds similar enough to your proprietary text documents, so an LLM trained on internet text can understand your documents. But a lot of businesses have images that look nothing like internet images, which is why you do much better with LVMs adapted to a particular domain. The internet, say sites like Instagram, has pictures of people, pets, landmarks, everyday objects, but this is what images in commercial computer vision use cases look like. For PCB inspection, aerial imagery, medical images. Many businesses have images that look very different from internet images. Take pathology. If you take a generic LVM trained on internet images, it'll learn features that look like this. You notice that the features are pretty diffuse and non-specific and don't particularly highlight any of the important aspects of the image. In contrast, we've adapted an LVM to the pathology domain specifically, and it gets features that look like this, which do a much better job capturing the most important features. Here's another example. And again, the domain-specific LVM does much better understanding pathology images. Here's another example from semiconductor manufacturing. A generic LVM learns features like this. Notice how it's not very good at picking up the lower wire. But a domain-specific LVM, which we've trained using unlabeled data to work specifically on semiconductor images, recognizes the most important features on semiconductor images.
But what is that really good for? Well, it turns out that if you have a domain-specific LVM, you can use it to quickly build a computer vision application for that domain. After training a domain-specific LVM on 100,000 unlabeled images, this graph shows the amount of labeled data needed to achieve different accuracies. The red curve is the performance of a generic LVM, but with a domain-specific LVM, as you can see, error rates are much lower. On the tests we've run, the domain-specific LVM shows a 36% to 52% reduction in model errors compared to existing methods using generic LVMs. But even more important, once you've built a domain-specific LVM, you can save a lot of time when building a computer vision system for your domain. The domain-specific LVMs act as a pre-built template and eliminates the need to construct a new model from scratch, which demands substantial effort. In our experiments, domain-specific LVMs need only 10 to 30% as much labeled data as generic LVMs to achieve comparable performance. We've found that it's possible to get a domain-specific LVM working using as few as 100,000 unlabeled images, though performance could be even better with even larger data sets. So, if you have a large proprietary set of images that look different from, say, internet images, LVMs might offer a way to unlock considerable value from your data. If you'd like to learn more about domain-specific LVMs, feel free to visit us at landing.ai.